Today's we are going to discuss the last part, that is part 4 of unit 1. We will start with the four different type of gas power cycles. Those are commonly used and they are as follows. Number one is Otto cycle, it is also known as petrol cycle. Second one is diesel cycle and third one is Breton cycle. While Otto cycle is widely used in petrol engines, diesel cycle is used in diesel engines, and dual cycle, that is also known as Breton cycle, are extensively used in gas turbine engines. First, we will start with the Otto cycle. As you can see in the figure, Otto cycle is a gas power cycle that is used in spark ignition internal combustion engine. The engine, those are coming now today's modern petrol, you can see the modern petrol engines. This cycle was introduced by Dr. Nicholas August Otto. He was a German engineer. An Otto cycle consists of four processes. Number one is two isotronic process and two processes are isochronic. As we have discussed in the last part, isochronic is a reversible adiabatic process, means in adiabatic there was no exchange of heat from surrounding. So isi ka reverse hai, isentropic. Process in Otto cycle consists of four processes. We can discuss all these four processes through the pressure volume diagram and temperature entropy diagram. In process 1 to 2, as you can see in the figure, that is isentropic compression. In this process, the piston moves from bottom to dead center. Actually, in a cylinder, piston moves from bottom to upwards. There is certain limit for the movement of piston. The lower limit is known as bottom down center and the upper limit is known as top dead center. This is known as BDC, bottom dead center, and top dead center, TDC position. Air undergoes reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic compression will be occur in this process. In process 1 to 2, compression is a process in which volume decreases and pressure increases. As you know, in compression always volume decreases and pressure increases. Hence, in this process you can see in the figure, volume of air decreases from V1 to V2. This is very clear in your pressure volume diagram. And you can see in temperature entropy diagram, that is TS diagram, temperature increases from T1 to T2. As this an isentropic process, entropy will remain constant. Delta S is equal to 0. It means S1 is equal to S2. Process 2 to 3 is known as constant volume heat addition. In process 2 to 3 is isochronic, that is constant volume heat addition process. In this process, piston remains at the top dead center, that piston will be at TDC for a moment. At that moment, heat is added at constant volume, that is V2 is equal to V3, from an external heat source. Temperature increases from T2 to T3, as you can see in temperature entropy diagram. Pressure increases from P2 to P3, as you can see in pressure volume diagram. And entropy, again you can see in TS diagram, entropy increases from S2 to S3. In process 3 to 4, that is isentropic expansion. In this process, air undergoing isentropic reversible adiabatic expansion, the piston is pushed from top dead center, that is TDC, to bottom dead center, PDC position, here pressure decreases from P3 to P4 and volume rises from V3 to V4, temperature falls from T3 to T4 as you can see in temperature entropy diagram, and entropy remains constant because in isentropic process delta S is equal to Q by T. As you know, delta S is equal to zero, that will remain constant. So temperature falls from T3 to T4, but entropy remains constant. In the reverse process, from 4 to 1, constant volume heat rejection will occur in this process. The piston rests at bottom dead center for a moment and heat is rejected as constant volume. Now the V4 will become V1. In this process, pressure falls from P4 to P1, temperature decreases from T4 to D1, and entropy falls from S4 to S1. The next is a diesel cycle. Diesel cycle is a gas power cycle invented by Rudolf Diesel in the year 1897. It is widely used in diesel engine. Diesel cycle is similar to Otto cycle or petrol cycle, except in the fact that it has one constant pressure process instead of a constant volume process. In Otto cycle there was constant volume, but in Otto cycle there will be a constant pressure process. Process in diesel cycle. Diesel cycle has four processes, and they are in process 1. Process 1 will be isentropic process, that is reversible adiabatic process, compression. In process 1 to 2, there will be isentropic compression. That is, isentropic means reversible adiabatic. In reversible adiabatic, there will be no exchange of heat from surrounding. Theek hai? And next process will be 2 to 3. That is constant pressure, that is also known as isobaric heat addition. And again 3 to 4 isentropic expansion. And the last one is process 4 to 1, that will be isochoric process or constant volume process. In that process heat will be rejected. In process 1 of diesel engine, process 1 to 2, that is isentropic compression. In this process, as you can see through the pressure volume diagram and temperature entropy diagram, the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center position. Air is compressed isentropically inside the cylinder. Pressure of air increases from P1 to P2. Temperature increases from T1 to T2. And volume decreases from V1 to V2. Entropy remains constant because this is a isentropic compression. In isentropic process, entropy will always constant. So entropy remains constant. That is, S1 is equal to S2. And you can see the W in the figure. W in is work is done on the system in this process from 1 to 2. You can see in pressure volume diagram. And in TS diagram, you can also see from 1 to 2, there is a W in. The piston is forced from top dead center to bottom dead center in the cylinder. Pressure of air now decreases from P3 to P4, and in TS diagram, you can see temperature decreases from T3 to T4 and volume increases from V3 to V4. Entropy will remain constant, that is S3 is equal to S4. Now the work output, that is known as W out, is equal to work is done by the system in this process from 3 to 4. Process 2 to 3, constant pressure heat addition. In this process, heat is added at constant pressure from an external heat source. Volume increases from V2 to V3. Temperature increases from T2 to 3T. And entropy, now the entropy will also increase. Now entropy increases from S2 to S3. In the process 3 to 4, that is again isentropic, but here is isentropic expansion. Here the compressed and heated air is expanded isentropically inside the cylinder. The piston is forced from top dead center to bottom dead center in the cylinder. Pressure of air increases from P3 to P4. And the temperature, you can see in TS diagram, now the temperature decreases from T3 to T4 and volume increases from V3 to V4. Entropy remains constant just because of isentropic process. Entropy will constant, that is S3 is equal to S4. Now the output will be W out, work is done by the system in this process. Now the reverse process 4 to 1, that will be constant volume heat rejection process. In this process, heat is rejected at a constant volume. So V4 will be equal to V1. Pressure decreases from P4 to P1 temperature. Pressure decreases from P4 to P1, and the temperature in TS diagram, you can see, decreases from T4 to T1, and entropy decreases from S4 to S1. Now the last cycle is Breton power cycle. Modern Breton engines are almost always a turbine type, although Breton only made piston engines. In the original 19th century Breton engines, ambient air is drawn into a piston compressor where it is compressed ideally, an isentropic process. The compressed air then runs through a mixing chamber where fuel is added, an isobaric process. The pressurized air and fuel mixture is then ignited in an expansion cylinder and energy is released, causing the heated air and combustion products to expand through a piston or cylinder, another ideally isentropic process. Gas turbines are also Breton engines. This also has three components: a gas compressor, a burner or combustion chamber, and an expansion turbine. Now you can see the ideal Breton cycle. Number one, isentropic process. The first process will be isentropic process. In this process, ambient air is drawn into the compressor. As you can see in the figure, there is compressor and fuel air combustion will be done in the combustion area, and that goes to the turbine, and turbine exhausted the gases, and we will get the work output. So in the first process, that will be isentropic process, there will be ambient air into the compressor where it is pressurized or compressed. Next process is isobaric process. Now the compressed air from the compressor then runs through a combustion chamber where fuel is burned. Heating that air which came from compressor, a constant pressure process, since the chamber is open to flow in and out. Third process will be isentropic process. The heated pressurized air then gives up its energy. The energy will be discharged by the combustion chamber. And expanding through a turbine, this gives up its energy, and expanding through a turbine, that combustion, after that combustion process, the pressurized air goes to the turbine or series of turbines. There will be more than one turbine. Some of the work extracted by the turbine is used to drive the compressor. The last process is isobaric process or heat rejection in the atmosphere. Thank you very much.